Hello, friends. How are you doing today? Today, we're talking about the fruit of the spirit of faithfulness. It is going to be amazing. But before we learn all about it, let's play a game. Today, we will be playing a game called Scavenger Hunt. Here's how to play. When I say go, you will have 30 seconds to find whatever I call out. Are you ready? The first item will be something that makes noise. This can be an instrument or maybe even your dog that barks. Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go! Okay, next, let's find an animal. This can be a stuffed animal or some animal crackers. Are you ready? Are you sure? On your mark, get set, go! Wow, you guys are so fast. Now, let's find a silly hat. You can pick anything you want. It can be some socks, a pillow, or even a banana. Do you know what you're gonna get? Okay, on your mark, get set, go! Great job. Okay, for our last round, we're gonna put everything back that we found. Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go! Job, friends, that was so much fun. You guys are pro scavenger hunters. Now let's take a look at our memory verse.
Hi, boys and girls. Are you ready to learn our memory verse? It's found in Galatians 5:22, and it says, fruit comes from having the Holy Spirit in our lives. So let's stand to our feet so we can learn this together. Are you ready? Awesome. When we say fruit, we can hold out our hands like we are holding something, like this. Can you all do that? Great job! Next, when we say comes from having, we'll pull our hands closer to us. Can you practice that? Awesome job! And when we say the Holy Spirit, we can point up with both fingers. Let's see you do that. Great job! Now last, when we say in our lives, we will point to ourselves with our thumbs like this. Good job. Okay, now let's do it all together. I'll say it first, and then you repeat after me when you're doing the motions. Are you ready? Fruit comes from having the Holy Spirit in our lives. Galatians 5:22. That was amazing. Now, let's say it again. Are you ready? Awesome. Fruit comes from having the Holy Spirit in our lives. Galatians 5:22. Great job. Now, let's say it one more time, but this time, let's say it as quiet as possible. Are you ready? Here we go. Fruit comes from having the Holy Spirit in our lives. Galatians 5:22. Wow, you guys were super quiet. You did a great job. Now, stay standing on your feet because it is time to declare the Word of God. We declare God's Word because it is... That's right, it is powerful. Let's declare it as loud as we can in 1, 2, 3, 4. Was awesome. It was so good to declare God's word over our lives. Stay standing with me and let's get ready for worship.
Your everyone. I hope you're having a great day. My day today has been so fun. My mom packed me the most delicious lunch this morning, and I went with my friends to the park. We were outside all day. Oh, we had so much fun. I actually forgot about my lunch, so I'm gonna eat it now because I am so hungry. Oh, no, 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 no! My fruit snacks are melted. My tuna and peanut butter sandwich is moldy.
Hey, Sam, what's wrong? And what is that smell?
My yummy lunch that my mom packed went bad in the sun.
Oh, no. Oh, this banana looks pretty bad.
It was gonna be so good, but now no more.
I am so sorry about your lunch, Sam. It's never fun when food goes bad.
I just wish there was something that was good all the time and never ever went bad.
Actually, Sam, I know of something that doesn't change.
Are you talking about canned food? Because even that has an expiration date on it.
No, not canned food. It's...
Hey, please tell me it's not Brussels sprouts. I do not like Brussels sprouts.
No, it is not Brussels sprouts. I'm actually talking...
Then what is it? Never changing, always good thing? I must know.
There is only one who never changes. And it's God.
God never changes?
That's right.
Never?
Never.
Never, ever, 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 ever?
Yes, never, ever. And the Bible actually tells us this in Malachi 3:6. God says, I am the Lord, I do not change. And there's another verse that describes God as faithful.
God is playful? What kind of toys does he play with? I bet he likes a choo-choo train or maybe Legos. He's very creative, you know.
Not playful, faithful.
Oh, well, you should have just said faithful. Faithful. What does faithful mean?
Faithful means constant, true, never changing. Really, it just means that God stays the same.
I know God's love for me never changes. Is that faithful?
Yes, it is, Sam. That's a perfect example of God's faithfulness.
Wow, I love God. He's the best. I want to be faithful like him.
Well, we can be faithful, Sam. Faithfulness is a fruit of the Holy Spirit. We receive it from God himself.
So, the Holy Spirit gives me faithfulness?
Yes, and that's our main point for today. The Holy Spirit gives me faithfulness. Let's say it like this. The Holy Spirit gives me faithfulness. Can we all say it together? You ready?
The Holy Spirit gives me faithfulness.
Great job, everyone.
So, what are some ways I can be faithful?
That is a great question, Sam. Just like God always keeps his promises, we can be faithful by keeping our word. Let's say your mom asks you to clean your room before dinner, and you promise her that you will. You can be faithful by remembering to do what you said and get your room cleaned.
Wow, keeping our promises is a big deal. Well, how else can I be faithful?
Well, you can be faithful in little things too, like brushing your teeth in the morning when you wake up, or before you go to bed at night. We can be faithful to tell the truth all the time, no matter what.
Wow, there are a lot of ways that we can be faithful, but Miss Amy, what happens if we forget or we mess up?
Well, it's okay, Sam, and God understands. His faithfulness will never run out in our hearts because he loves us and he is always here to help us. Let's say our main point one more time to help us remember.
The Holy Spirit gives me faithfulness.
Great job.
Well, Miss Amy, can I ask the Holy Spirit for more faithfulness?
Yes, we can always ask for more because God's faithfulness never runs out. Friends, let's pray and ask God to help us to be faithful. You ready? Dear God, Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you that you love us and you never change. Please help us to be faithful in everything. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
It was so much fun having church with you today. I can't wait to learn about another fruit of the Holy Spirit. We love you and we'll see you next week.